The new season is finally upon us, and honestly, I'm pretty excited. I'd even go as far as to say that it's a whole new game. I mean, sure, the items have been around for 2 months now, and there hasn't been much new characters, but at least now I could find out what late game feels like as 5 humans versus 5 humans. Because if I'm being honest, most of my preseason games felt like 5 humans versus 3 monkeys, because 2 players would inevitably disconnect on my team after raging, and I myself am a monkey as well. But the season is back, and we can rejoice, give each other high fives, and celebrate, and oh my god, I went 1-9 in my placements. Normally, when League of Legends starts a new season, your game is based on the coin flip gods. Sure, you might go 6-0 top lane, but since it's placements, your bot lane might be 2 irons against a gold and Faker himself. So figure it out. I'll use one of my games as an example. The first placement game I had this season, I had a Yone mid that went 0-9. I was pissed. But unfortunately, the problem was only exacerbated by the fact that I myself was 0-10 on Yasuo top. The rest of my games didn't do too hot either. So as a person who has done basically every single wrong thing you can do in his placement games, I've come to bear knowledge onto you from the future. And I will give you tips on how to survive early season 11 and your placement games. Unless you already did your placements, then I am sorry I wasn't fast enough. But before we dive into the list, did you know that the majority of the people watching this video aren't subscribed to the channel? If you subscribe, you'll really help us out. It's a new year, we're figuring things out, and it's the best time to sub, so if you haven't done it, please do. You'll help the channel out. I love you if you do, I love you if you don't. Now let's get into the list. Number 1. Prioritize comfort. Look, we get it. Yone's out, Samira's new, Viego is hot as shit. But just because these champions are enticing and shiny and new doesn't mean that you should fall for the trap, especially since everyone else is already doing that. If you want to survive your placement games, just stick to the champions that you're comfortable with, no matter what. So if you have 1,000 games on Twisted Fate, stick to Twisted Fate. I mean, sure, all the knowledge that you accumulated over the last few years is completely useless because there's 47,000 new items that can one-shot you, grant invisibility, or give people a dash, but at least you'll know when your W's up. On top of that, I myself am a firm believer of practice over power. Bruce Lee once said, "Fear not the person that practiced 1,000 kicks once, fear the person that practiced 1 kick 1,000 times. And you have to be the person that practiced 1 kick 1,000 times, even if all the new champions in the game come at you with 1,000 different kicks. Number 2, CS is important. Let me explain. It's placements. You don't know how good your team is going to be. You don't know how bad their team is going to be. Almost nothing is certain except for one thing, and that's these little fucking angels right here. While everyone is dealing with conflicting egos, inaccurate pings, or team objectives, whatever the fuck that is, these little bags of money have only one thing on their mind. And that's murder. As long as you're playing your laning phase correctly, these little bags of gold will consistently run at you and beg to be murdered. And since everyone else, especially at this time of season, is too busy yelling at each other and having a pissing contest about what elo they belong in, you can keep your head down and focus on getting perfect CS. And if you do everything right, mute all your allies and all of your enemies, you'll be able to get a mythic item and a pair of boots before the enemy Graves comes in with a collector and one-shots your entire team. That's an achievement. Number 3, this one is very important, and listen to me. Do not jungle. Stay out of the jungle. I'm gonna repeat myself, do not jungle right now. If you need me to say it in Spanish, no entras a la selva. But Scooch, what if I'm a jungle main and I only play a Mumu or Lilia? Well, buddy, take that ass top lane because the jungle is not worth the headache. I'm serious, as a jungle main, when you play jungle, ganking is sometimes a coin flip. For example, if you gank top without research, maybe you're ganking top lane for somebody who doesn't play that champion and then they are effectively useless in your gank. Or maybe you ganked the 900 100,000 mastery point Tryndamere who is going to win the game off of your early pressure. Unless you do your research, that's always what it's going to boil down to in lower elos. But now that elo is everywhere, instead of it being a coin flip, it's a goddamn D20. Except instead of the dice being 1 through 20, it's the number 20, 18 separate skulls, and on one side, a slur. Did you gank top and get a kill? Well, that's not going anywhere because he's the bad one. And your bot laner has only played ARAM their entire life, so that's not the right choice either. But hey, bud, look at the bright side. Your mid laner is playing on the NA server from Brazil, so they're constantly disconnecting and not actively inting. That's kind of a plus. I'm serious, stay out of the jungle right now if you value your sanity. At least give it a few more weeks before picking the role back up. And now this last point is going to be strange. But I feel this last point is by far the most important. And it's actually the reason why I made this video. And that is... number 4. Have fun. I know this point is a loaded gun, and I can already detect the 50 people typing quickly on their keyboards, League of Legends isn't fun, LOL XD. But listen, ranked right now is a fucking battleground. There's Smurfs dominating bronze players that end up losing their game because that bronze player had a bigger Smurf on their team. And honestly, the volatile state of the game makes it miserable if you only focus on one thing. Winning. We get it. You want to win. Everybody wants to win. I don't think there's much people who queue up wanting to lose. But since a lot of these factors aren't in your hand right now, and since ranks are going to be stabilizing themselves for the next few weeks or so, I'm letting you know that you're not going to have a good time if you only go focusing on the dub. I'm not saying to give up. It is possible to go 10-0 in your placements. It's just not in your hands unless you're an absolute god at this game. Or incredibly lucky. Take a breath and understand that you're gonna end up in the rank that you belong in by the end of the season. And find things to focus on and improve your play no matter the outcome of the game. Whether it be CS or vision score or just map pressure, there's always something to focus on and get better at. In fact, I streamed myself going 1-9 in my placements. And even though I ended up losing 90% of the games I played, I had so much fun because I was making bets with chat on stream. Like how many Dark Harvest stacks I can get on Shaco. Or if I could eat 15 people in a Cho'Gath game. Or if I could get 600 stacks on Nasus. There was even a game where I bet if I could heal over 20,000 damage on Kane, and just look at this.
Touched by the fountain so I can heal. All right.
Oh no! No!
Oh my god, I
didn't do it!
Chat, come on, drum roll, please! Let's see damage healed. Total damage to objectives, total damage dealt.
Yes! Yes! Let's fucking go!
Oh my god, it does not get easier!
And finding little fun things like that have really helped me get through the bitterness that is early season. It was really some of the most fun I've had playing this game. If you guys want to participate on bets, because we're going to still be doing that, follow my stream at twitch.tv/scoochlive, because this year I'm making it a goal to stream as much as I can. Our climb is starting at silver 4, so let's hope for the best. I'm pretty sure I can hit gold in 3 days, but we'll see. Early season games are now and have always been a cesspool of toxicity, but that doesn't mean you have to let it limit your ability to enjoy the game. I wish you luck in your early season matches and in your placement games. And if you're anywhere near silver 4 right now, I'll probably see you on the Rift. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. This is the first video essay of the year, so that's actually pretty exciting. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm so glad to be back, and we're gonna do whatever we can for this channel to have even more frequent content. We don't want it to just be 3 days anymore. I'm gonna try to become daily, but that's gonna be a lot of back-end stuff. Okay, that's it. I love you. Click the video that's on the screen. 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 Click the video that's on the screen.